disappointment and heartache. Those are the words pro-life advocates in Illinois are using to describe their reaction to the passage of a pro-abortion bill in the state's House of Representatives. The Reproductive Health Act would lessen restrictions on abortions later in pregnancy, remove criminal penalties for physicians that perform abortion, and expand insurance coverage for procedures and contraception. Joining me now by Skype is Bishop Thomas John Paprocki of the Diocese of Springfield in Illinois. Your Excellency, welcome back to our broadcast.
Hello, good to be with you.
You have called the passage of this Reproductive Health Act a gravely immoral action and evil. The Catholic Conference of Illinois issued a statement saying that it sends a message to everyone in our state that life is cheap. You and your brother bishops, what's your message? What are you going to do? How are you going to urge the Illinois Senate to reject this?
Well, I think we have to be clear that this kind of legislation is gravely immoral, and we have to keep saying that. You know, the Second Vatican Council in the document on the pastoral constitution on the church in the modern world, Gaudium et Spes, called abortion and infanticide abominable crimes. And Pope Francis himself has called abortion a very grave crime. And so we have people that are basically pushing for something that's criminal from a moral point of view. So the House of Representatives in Illinois, unfortunately, earlier this week did pass that bill, Senate Bill 25, the so-called Reproductive Health Act. It had passed out of the Senate committee today and probably will be taken up for a vote either this evening or tomorrow. The Senate adjourns tomorrow, so they're probably going to do something by tomorrow. And unfortunately, it looks like something will pass, and the governor has already said he wants to make Illinois the
Pritzker,
most abortion-friendly state in the union, so he's definitely going to sign this.
Do you think that Illinois will then move in the direction of New York State, where abortion is allowed till the moment of birth?
Well, yes, I think this legislation already does that. It removes any protection for fetal life, and it basically says that you can have an abortion right up until the moment of birth. And so it says that there are no rights enjoyed by an unborn baby. And so I think it is very, very extreme in that regard. Even in Roe versus Wade, which supposedly this is supposed to help reinforce, Roe versus Wade talks about viability. And this legislation just throws viability out the window, too. Even a viable baby can be legally aborted under this bill.
It was an emotional debate on the floor in tears. A state representative, Avery Bourne, a Republican who was pregnant, called the measure a massive expansion that will impact viable babies. A Democrat, Kelly Cassidy, said this war on women is coming to Illinois. I say not on my watch. What do you make of the timing of all of this? Do you think that the passage of pro-life legislation in Alabama and other states played a role?
Well, that's what I'm hearing, that supposedly the push for this Reproductive Health Act in Illinois is a reaction to the passage of the bills in Georgia and Alabama. Actually, that's false. You know, Jesus said that the devil is the father of lies, and there are a lot of lies that are being told about this whole situation. So there was a bill that was passed 2 years ago and signed into law by the then Republican governor who did not win for re-election. But basically that bill not only provided for taxpayer funding of abortion, but also said that if Roe versus Wade is ever overturned, that abortion would remain legal in Illinois. So they already took measures in response to anticipating that Roe versus Wade may be overruled. So this new legislation this year goes far beyond that and actually is not even needed according to those stated ambitions or intentions that they have on their part.
Well, we'll check in tomorrow to see what happens. Bishop Thomas John Paprocki of the Diocese of Springfield in Illinois, thanks for joining us.
You're welcome. Thank you.